Guys, CSGO is a game balanced on a mere thread. One little tweak from Daddy Valve and shit can get out of hand real fast. So what is the most broken gun in the history of Counter-Strike Global Offensive? Well, from pistols that were better than rifles to the coming of the augpocalypse, here are the top 10 most broken guns in all of CSGO. Starting us off at number 10 is the pre-nerf AWP. Now, we know this one is a bit of a contentious one, but after so many years, the benefit of hindsight has shown us just how broken the pre-nerf AWP really was.
You remember before they did the AWP update, that was too much.
Yeah, one guy.
With increased movement speed, an AWPer could single-handedly change the outcome of the game, regardless of what opposition came their way. We witnessed the true potential of the pre-nerf Arctic Warfare Police in the hands of French superstar Kenny S.
We can see where he's looking now, just hits the shot barely on MSL, finds the second one, Kenny S, point blank with the no-scope! Kenny S sucks it down and Titan, they managed to get another round!
And although it's not like the 2015 rework made the gun by any means unusable, it just wasn't the same. Just ask Kenny.
This is not okay! This needs to stop now!
Taking the number 9 spot, we have the run and gun update. Valve's philosophy when it comes to updating CSGO seems like they're always trying to balance around a problem rather than addressing it directly. And in 2015, Valve changed the SMGs with the hope of tackling the Tech 9. This update allowed for players to run around like absolute maniacs, popping heads in the process, and creating an environment where you can run and gun in a game where you're really not supposed to.
It's cool to hear that and then see it kind of go into play.
Oh, it's cool to see the MAC-10 just rushing right up through the Molotov and Nico's all alone. And that's Flush out with a third.
What is he doing, man?
Coming in at the number 8 spot is the 2014 iteration of the CZ-75. In the earlier days of CSGO, this gun had it all. In fact, maybe it had a little bit too much. You could pull it out in almost any situation. With incredible running accuracy, a high rate of fire, and incredible damage, this pistol made any eco a nightmare. All while costing just $500 with a $300 kill reward.
Of a generation. Molotov's in, set piece out. Shroud has let them all pass. One, two, three! Oh, Jesus, the last one alive! Oh, that is tied at the game into overtime!
If there was any gun that could get you back into the game in a single round, well, this was probably it.
Series 4 deatomizer.
That's what I'm talking about.
Noisy cricket.
Hey, Kay, no, come on, man. You get a Series 4 deatomizer, I get a little midget cricket. Oh, yeah.
At the number 7 spot on our list is the balance change that basically put the M4 out of business, at least for a while. We're talking about the 2019 AUG. For the bulk of CSGO's patch history, the AUG was left relatively untouched and was always seen to be well balanced because of its price. But with one price change, CSGO's metagame would be turned completely on its head. The AUG had all the tools to dominate the game, and when it became a little more affordable, it did.
Really not having you at time of it. Just jumping up on the box. He's going to get the shot easy. But Sip is left, and out of all the players you wouldn't want a 1v1 against, maybe Sip is the ultimate.
Oh!
What? Somehow, it didn't even take anything.
In a matter of months, the AUG became the rifle of choice for the CTs. It single-handedly made the game CT-sided, and just when players were adapting, Valve nerfed it.
What the fuck you say to me, you little shit? You shut up when I'm talking to you! You shut your mouth! You kiss your mother with that mouth? It's called you kiss your mother with that fucking mouth?
On its way to the 6th spot on our list is the 2017 UMP. In October of 2014, Valve rolled out an SMG update, which allowed for 20% more armor penetration across the board. At first, this went relatively unnoticed, with teams opting for the tried and true Galil or FAMAS. But once teams started to catch on, it became the force buy dream, and the bane of any full buy.
Device waiting perfectly for them to walk to secret. They're all walking in a clothesline. Device gets all four, all on a UMP, and he's got money. As Kiabi takes down JKS.
You hate to see that.
What are those Neanderthals up to?
Don't they know I'm busy spoiling myself?
For the number 5 spot, we welcome you to 5 Heaven. Picking up where the Tech 9 left off, the 5-7 grew to prominence as an essential eco weapon which would dismantle any full buy in its path.
RPK's gonna stay in Goose and keep himself pretty much concealed for the most part. Oh, the 5-7 come dead, it gets himself 3 kills! Cammy now has the challenge, the bomb's loose, it's gonna be an L1 for RPK, he shuts down Astralis, they make money early and they get it taken out of their pockets.
Incredibly accurate and incredibly mobile, this pistol could do it all, and in many cases could go toe-to-toe with the stronger weapons in the game.
Here it is, the only caveat that they have that strategy, and that's the fake it and go inner.
Is it going to be the classic win?
Close it out on an eco. Eco with the 3K. Make it 4 with the 5-7. And what is that? What is that?
5-7 left more than a few players frustrated with how helpless they were at the sight of heaven. And if you were one of them, well, we're sorry. Taking the number 4 spot on our list is the gun that forged a new meaning for the phrase eco round. That's right, it's the 2015 Tech 9.
It will once again just be eco. Is he about to pull off the Alamo? Oh, he's got 3 from behind quad. Can he find a 4th? He gets the 4th. He's on for the 8th and he gets it! What?
In 2014, Valve put a buff on the innocent little pistol, which drastically increased the accuracy in almost all situations. We're talking standing still, running, or even jumping.
This position, he's looking to jump up on the sky, and he's going to do it there, and he falls! What? Get right! Tagging down Device mid-air with the Tech 9. Device is going to be furious!
Once teams caught on, the Tech 9 era began. Every round became a threat to lose, with 5 players being able to take a site in mere seconds for minimal economic investment.
Although, oh my god, he gets another kill in now. Clock's running out, 7 seconds. Olofmeister looking for the kill, 5 seconds. He goes for it, it's a headshot, and it's gonna be the round done.
The gun did get nerfed in 2015, but it wouldn't be the last time we saw a pistol dominate the game. One tapping its way to the number 3 spot is the automatic pistol that pissed everybody off, from pros to silvers, in 2018, the CZ-75.
And somehow, they get it all the way through. Rain picking up 2 big kills, there's Happy coming through, the CZ-75, he's only got 4 bullets left, and Nico now all alone, he goes down, Happy finds the last kill with just 4 bullets. Unbelievable performance coming out of him.
Its stats made the gun essentially a mini rifle, where you could one-tap people rushing onto a site or be patient with multiple taps at farther range. And despite the community outcry, this meta would dominate the game for months.
Can you ask him only one question, and I believe many of them wants to know. When are you going to
nerf the CZ-75?
At the runner-up spot, we have the coming of the augpocalypse. For a very brief period in 2014, Valve sought to diversify the toolkit of the CTs, so they buffed the AUG with increased fire rate and decreased recoil. Combine that with the scope, and this created a monstrosity which tortured the CSGO community for 7 hellish days, known as AUG Week. Taking the top spot on our list is the brief period of time where CSGO turned into the Wild West. In a game with AK-47s and M4s and AWPs, all it took was one unbalanced six-shooter to throw the entire game on its head.
Literally with the right click, one-shotting somebody.
You can one-shot somebody with a fucking pistol! Why is that allowed? Look! What? Like, should that even be allowed? Are you fucking kidding me?
Introduced in the 2015 winter update, the R8 revolver broke everything on launch. It was a hand cannon that was incredibly cheap and could destroy your opponent with one shot in most areas. For just a couple of days, we all got to be cowboys. Well, guys, that was our list. What'd you think? Did we get it right? What is your personal most hated, most broken gun in CSGO? Honestly, when you're as bad as I am, they all seem pretty broken. Thanks for watching. If you want more content like this, hit the sub button and ring that notification bell. For unique bite-sized videos you won't find anywhere else, hit up our Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook pages.